A couple years ago, he was 19 at the time, before the world shut down, and he come to us and said, I met this girl. Okay, we all know that nothing good happens after the phrase, I met this girl, right? But most of the time, let's be honest, you know. And he said, she's doing this internship thing in Europe for the summer, and she wants me to fly over and meet her and backpack from France to Prague.
What?
And I said, let me ask you something, son. For $100 million, could you find either one of those places on a map? And my wife said, I think it sounds exciting. And I said, that's because you're the worst mother in America. He can't find the washer and dryer, you know? And but she let him go, so we packed him up, and we take him to the airport. And I said, I have a feeling this is like the beginning of the story of how we used to have this other kid. But we take him, and I made him some notes. And I said, I need you to listen to me. Son, your great-grandfather backpacked across Europe in 1943 under slightly different circumstances. And he was going to be in like five different places that he had been. And I said, I think this is so profound that, you know, time is weird and generations are weird. And you're going to go through these towns, you know, like Brussels and Luxembourg. And, you know, it's just so cool. We get to the airport. He gets out. He goes into the airport. He disappears. We drive off. And I looked at my wife and I said, I've got a bad feeling that my grandfather was in less danger with the Nazis than your son is with this girl. Right? Yeah. You've seen this movie.
Yes.
Well, it was about 3 days later, 7 o'clock Nashville time, he's calling me. And of course, my heart sank. Now, I'm not a mathematician, but I knew that was about 3 a.m. where he was. And I grabbed the phone, and I'm like, what's up? Him and the girl had broken up. Day 3 of a 14-day trip. And I said, and he's real upset. It's the middle of the night. And I said, where are you? I said, where did you break up? And he said, Paris. I said, my God, you lost the girl in Paris? There cannot be a greater or worse city in the world to lose the girl than Paris. I'm gonna make a fortune off of this story. Son, focus. I need you to start at the beginning and tell me everything she said. Right? I'm the worst father in the world.
Father of the Year, Lee Miller.
If you know this song, it was written about a tobacco farmer in Nicholasville, Kentucky, who went into the army as a private, and he came out as a private. And saved the world somewhere along the way. But I always say this about my grandfather. Yes. The most important part of that story was when he first got drafted, they sent him to Boston. And in Boston, he was in an anti-aircraft tank because they were afraid that the Germans were going to attack the United States. So for a year, he sat up there and watched the skies to protect Boston Harbor. The most important thing he did in that year in Boston is he knocked up my grandmother. The first time he saw my father was 2.5 years old. It was right after he did the dirty deed, they sent him to Europe. And this is about him. I said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all black and white. Neighbor glares at you there. He said, I was 11. Times were tough back in 35. It's me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm. read the proof. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Taken overseas in the middle of hell in 1943. In the wintertime, you can almost see my breath. That was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. You should have seen it in color. A picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep color. You should have seen it in color. Favorite one, that's me and Grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up the day we said our vows. You can't tell it here, but it was hot that June, that her rose is red and her eyes are blue, and just look at that smile, I was so proud. That's the story of my life, right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Pictures worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in color. Should've seen.